So, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Peter Köppel. I hope you can cope with my Swiss accent, because I know somebody is already joking about my Swiss accent, and I do not avoid this at the moment. As Rachel said, I'm involved in nucleotide applications since 1988. We did first some, also first of all, I would like to tell you I am a biochemist from profession and with a specialty in immunology. We have, in 88, we started with a company where we used our product since then, mostly in animal fields. And in animal nutrition, we avoid to use, to improve the immune system of the animals, to lower the use of antibiotics in the feed. And in this time, we have made quite a number of tests. All in all, we have made about between 400 and 500 different trials in the different animals. In 2006, we started with a company called ProBio, and since then, we also work with Rachel directly on the human side, because she was before also in the animal nutrition, she was involved. So now I would like to give you a little bit an introduction about nucleotides and their role in the body. And for that, I just go a little bit back in biochemistry. I do not go too low in biochemistry, but just to tell the body is in a constant change. So the body has always a demand for new cell, and the body is always forming and destroying cells. So we are, except of our brain, all only about between 5 and 7 years old. Except the brain, the body is between 5 and 6 years old. And we have different cells in the body which has a longer and a shorter lifetime. I come later back. But this formation of cells and the degradation of cells is needed a lot of nucleotides, because they are the building blocks of RNA and DNA. But nucleotides are not only in the cell renovation and in RNA, they are involved in most of or nearly all activities of our body. Now, just to give you a little bit insight on the DNA and the RNA, also we have the DNA is the genetic fingerprint of our body, and one DNA is consisting on 3 billion nucleotides. And we have 4 nucleotides which are forming, which are responsible for the DNA. We have guanine, cytosine, adenosine, and thymine. In the DNA, in the RNA, we have the same composition as here, but here thymidine is replaced by uracil. And we can generally say that you have about 1,000 times more RNA in the cell than DNA. So this shows you also the importance of RNA, because most of the people, they are familiar that DNA consists of nucleotides and need nucleotides, but a lot of people are not aware that RNA is also needed nucleotides. And for the RNA is the blueprint for the protein synthesis. So protein synthesis is very much depending on the production of RNA. So in here, I just give you an overview on the nucleotides. So we have 2 purines and 3 pyrimidines. I'm calculating very good. Huh? So I have the adenosine, and you see a purine is consisting on 2 double rings. Whereas the pyrimidines, they have 1 6 rings, and then they are combined with the sugar and the phosphate. So this is always the same. The sugar phosphate is always the same. Only the side frame is different, yes. So, and now, as I said before, when you have a cell multiplication, the cell multiplication or the doubling of a cell always start with the doubling of the DNA. So you have here a single, also a double strand. This strand open, and along each of the strand, a new strand is built up. And for one single doubling for one single cell, you need this amount of nucleotides. So the production of nucleotides is limiting the speed of the cell multiplication. Normally, the doubling of the DNA takes around, it depends a little bit on the single cell, but takes around 8 hours. But when the DNA is doubled, then the two RNAs, the two DNAs are separated and distributed on two different cells. This phase only takes 20 minutes. So the really long part for the cell multiplication is the doubling of the DNA. And as soon as you can, the production of the nucleotides is the most difficult part. So when you come from outside with nucleotides, you can speed up the whole cell multiplication. And this is very important, mostly in those organs or systems where you need quick cell multiplication. This is the gut, the immune system, and the liver, and some brain cells also. Now, here just the basic information. All cells have the same composition, from the bacteria up to the human. They carry a nucleus. They can proliferate and divide, and they can produce their own requirements, potentially. Then you see here again that the genetic information is depending on the number of this number of nucleotides. But the nucleotides are, as I told you before, not only responsible for the production of DNA, but nucleotides is also very important in the protein synthesis by the formation first of a messenger RNA, where the information is directly transferred from or transcribed from the DNA on the RNA. And then you have, it leaves the body, the cell, and then along the ribosome, the protein is formed. Now, we have here already the cell multiplication. We have here the protein synthesis, but we have further activities of the nucleotides. Because, for example, the body releases some hormones. The hormones come on the cell, outer part of the cell. And how is this information transported into the cell to have an activity in the cell? This is by forming some specific messenger, which we call second messenger, and these are also nucleotides parts. This is called cyclic AMP and cyclic CMP. And they activate some parts of the DNA to be, let's say, print out. But this print out needs energy. The whole energy in the body is transported by nucleotides, ATP, GTP, UTP. To produce energy, you need a metabolic activity of carbohydrates, fat, and proteins. All the enzymes degrading fat, carbohydrates, protein, they have cofactors, and these cofactors are based on nucleotides. So you see, nucleotides are, we think always that nucleotides are involved in the DNA. But it goes much further. It goes down to the whole metabolic activities of the body. Now, nucleotides, I call, and Rachel before, she already mentioned it, the forgotten nutrients, because all the recommendations which you have normally are on the content of proteins, fat, sugars, vitamins, trace elements, and minerals. And one major ingredient is not mentioned, they are nucleotides. And as you have seen, the nucleotides have really a really central role in the whole cellular development, but also in the reactivity of the immune system. And nucleotides, I come later on, nucleotides are found in very low availability in the diets, and mostly they are found in offals. I show you later some pictures. And nucleotides can only be really of help when they are given, additionally given, in a form which is easily available and which match with what is already in the food and what is produced in the body. So we have studied quite a long time what is the best combination of nucleotides here. Now, just to give you a little bit of information about where they come from. Also, the first way to get nucleotides is the salvage pathway. The nucleotides from dying cells are recycled, but only about 75 to 80%. The rest is excreted. Then the next way to get nucleotides is the de novo synthesis, but you need a lot of energy and a lot of time because, for example, to build the purines, you need 14 biochemical steps. And now something very important is this here, because some of the cell have not the potential to produce either nucleotides at all or enough nucleotides. The gastrointestinal cell, they have such a quick turnover that their capacity to produce nucleotides is much too low. And you need it from the food, because in the gut you can only get it from the food. You have no dying cells. The next, and here, the cells which come out of the bone marrow, also all the white and red blood cells, have not the capacity to produce all nucleotides. In the body, you have only one organ who can produce a surplus of nucleotides. This is the liver. And normally, when you have a disease, liver function is going down. So in a case where you have the highest need, the own production is the lowest. So then these nucleotides become what we call conditionally essential. To really do the job, the body can do the job, the nucleotides are in such a case where you have a disease or a high stress, they get essential. And here, and then also what I did not mention here, some of the brain cell cannot produce nucleotides. So the development, for example, in the children, when they have not enough nucleotides, it could be shown that the brain development was not optimal. And the best supply of nucleotides for children is mother milk. Compared to the milk of cow, mother milk has about 100 times more nucleotides. This means when you have a milk formula not supplemented with nucleotides, children have a low digestion, they have a lot immature lymphocytes, and they have a low brain development. So today, all the milk formulas for the first phase, sometimes even second phase, is supplemented with nucleotides. Then the third way to get nucleotides is absorption from the food. Now here we have problems, because the content of the food, you have a lot of difference in nucleotides, and the availability, because the nucleotides in the cell are quite good protected, so the availability is only about 5 to 10%. The rest is not used in the body. This means an external supplement of nucleotides saves energy and raw material. Because here, to make nucleotides, you need amino acids, several amino acids to produce nucleotides. So you save raw material. The external nucleotides support an active process because it needs an active process. And the external nucleotides needs to be really balanced to get an optimal effect. Now here I just show you the amount of nucleotides in different food ingredients. And you see, for example, in vegetable and food, you see here broccoli, and I have here differentiated between total nucleotides, purines, and pyrimidines. And you see here broccoli and cauliflower has quite a number of nucleotides, but the rest is very, very low, extremely low. Now, when you look on the next slide, you see, for example, beef. And you see here, also, but also, where you have the most, you see that we have, excuse me, I go back. You have here, let's say, all most of them, they are below 1% on dry matter. When you look here, you go up to 6% of the dry matter is nucleotides. But where it is? In the intestine. It is in the stomach. It is in the kidney. It is the lung. Who is eating this? No more. Nobody is eating this. So we draw away the most important part of an animal. We don't eat them. The same is in pork. So we have tested quite a lot of products, and you see again, intestine is very high. Lung is also quite high. It's quite good. Who is eating lung? Before it was, in all time, everybody was eating lung. And something very interesting, when you look at predator, let's say a lion, what he is eating first? He opened here, and then he started to eat the intestine. And nature, everything in nature makes sense. And now here, I just have a little bit a summary of other. Because people say, okay, I eat, for example, steak. Where are the nucleotide? Where are the nucleotide content in the steak? It's extremely low. For example, a good Marmite is not bad, but who is eating a lot of Marmite? Not everybody likes it. But you see, for example, everything that is has a quite quick turnover. For example, sprout. They are quite good. So nucleotide content in food is depending on the metabolic activity of the organ or the plant. So that when you have a plant which has a high metabolic activity, normally you find higher amount of nucleotides. But now, I mentioned before already, from this, the absorption is only this, down 10%. So even when you have high amount of nucleotides, the absorption is really low. So we speak at the moment, nucleotides are essential products in the food. It goes in the same direction as vitamins. Now I just made us some calculation that you are a little bit impressed. We have seen here the number of nucleotides needed for the DNA production. In a human being, every day, two billion are replaced every day. So the need only for blood cells, not for nothing else, not for the gut. The gut is much bigger. Only for blood cells, you need this amount of single nucleotides. So this is extremely impressive also for me. And here you see, I repeat here what I have told before, where nucleotides are also needed. But this is only for the cell multiplication. And as I told you before, the need here for the RNA is about 1,000 times higher than this one here. So imagine how much we need every day and what the body is doing. And here I just give you a little bit an overview of lifespan of different cell, organs or cells. The only cells which are really lifetime are brain cells. Bone cells, they have about 25 to 30 years. Muscle cells, between 10 and 16 years. Fat cells, 8 years. And then everything is less than a year. And here, for example, neutrophils is 1 to 5 days. Stomach is 2 days. And the small intestine, between 4 and 5 days. Now I just would like to go here. Our body has a surface of about 2 square meters. The lung has a surface of about 20 square meters. And the intestine is between 200 and 500 square meters. This is a tennis place, the tennis court. And every 5 days, all the cells are replaced. You can imagine what kind of nucleotides ingredients they are needed in the gut. And we always said health starts in the gut. Now, this is, I already mentioned this before, but now I would like to tell you what we are doing. Also, we have, Rachel already said that we are producing 2 different products. But all our products are made on purified nucleotides. So they are pure nucleotides combined with RNA. So we have uridine, thymidine, cytosine, adenosine, guanosine, and combination with nucleotides, with RNA. Now, I go quick back. When you look here, and you see it all the time the same, when you look on the amount of purines compared with the pyrimidines, purine is always about 60-70%, and pyrimidines only 30%. This means what we are doing here, we have much more of these nucleotides, we add more of these nucleotides, and very few of these. This means at the end of the day, we can, it's not 100%, we try to balance this, because for a cell multiplication or DNA production, you need a balanced amount of nucleotides. And we try with our products here to get a full balance of the nucleotides. So now I come a little bit on more specifically on the effects of nucleotides in the body. So the first effect is the metabolic activity. Transfer of energy, hormone signal, I told you before. And then, very important, tissue repair. And here, gut integrity, DNA repair, and protein synthesis. Now, nucleotides, as I told you before, are part of very important enzymes. So it is really involved in all metabolic activity. We have even seen that some of the enzymes, the digesting enzymes in the gut are increased. That you have, for example, more degradation maltase, also higher maltase, also sugar starch is better digested. Then we have here seen the synthesis of nucleotides. And here, for example, you see metabolic activity. We have done a trial here in UK with athletes, and we measured after 90 minutes the endurance, we measured the lactate, and we found the lactate formation was 7 times lower compared to the control group. Interesting is also here, this one here, because cortisol is a typical stress hormone. And we always found, and we just had got a new trial from America, and we found that the cortisol formation is lower. This means people can support stress better with a good nucleotide product. Oh, sorry. Then we measured also the immune globulins in the mouse. And in the mouse you have so-called IgA antibodies. And after 90 minutes of high activity, the immune globulins in the mouse went down really drastically, up about 90% down. And when we had nucleocell active, we have 20%, 25% less decrease. We have also a decrease, but the decrease was much lower compared to the control group. So this is the effect on the whole metabolic activity. Now, as I have said before, all our activities need energy. And the universal source of energy are ATP, GTP, UTP. You have no other means to transport energy in the body. So all our activities are depending on nucleotides. Then here you see, this is the nucleotide. You have here ATP, and you see this triple phosphoric acid carries the energy, and this is cut away and can then transfer the energy into a metabolic activity. I do not go in all the details here. Now here the hormone effect. And you see you have a first messenger, for example, a hormone. The hormone comes on a receptor. And then you have here the so-called G proteins. They are either inhibited, you have an inhibition or a stimulation. And depending on this, you have more or less of cyclic AMP. And this cyclic AMP afterwards activates the DNA to produce some proteins or reduce the proteins. So to see, without nucleotides, the whole hormone activity could not happen in a body. Very important, and we are doing some trials in America now, is the effect on wound healing. Because the first step in the wound healing is always the activity of the macrophages. Macrophages are going into a wound, and they start, because you have a lot of debris in a wound, and they have to clean the wound. And only when the wound is really cleaned from all the debris, then the macrophages change their behavior and send out some signals to activate the surrounding cells to multiply and close the wound. When the immune system, and I told you before, all white blood cells cannot produce nucleotides. And we have made tests in our own labs, and we found when we stimulate the body, also when we stimulate animals with an immune stimulator, we found in combination with nucleotides about four to ten times more macrophages. So the activity is extremely quick, and we have seen extremely good effect on the immune system. Now here's something very important. Because we are, a lot of people, when you have, let's say, stress, even an immune reaction always release oxygen radicals. And here we did a trial, this was in animals, and we see we have in all three groups, we have the same energy level. But in this group, only 2% came out of PUFA. Whereas in this group where we have replaced the starch by linseed oil, 21% came out of PUFA. And here we have the same composition as here, but here we added some nucleotides. And what we measured, we took the DNA out of lymphocytes and put it on an electrophoresis. And then we stained. And on an electrophoresis, you know, the DNA is about so long. Of each cell, you have about, the DNA is about a meter long. So when you have this kind of situation, you find all the stain here on the place where you put the nucleotide. Only when you have damage, also when the DNA is cut in smaller pieces, you find like a tail. And therefore it's called comet test. It looks then like a comet. And what we have seen here, this was the control group. So here you have very little, about 5% of damage. Then this was the oil group, and you see here you have this tail, and you found this amount of damage. When you have the same oil group, but you add nucleotides, you go back to this one. You see here now, when we look on day zero, we have in all three groups, also before we started with oil treatment, we have about 96% intact DNA, all the same. After 21 days, here we have still the starch, also no development of PUFAs and no development of oxygen radicals. You have here still 96%, but here have 10% more damage. And these cells, they go to die. When we combine this oil with nucleotides, we go back to the normal. That is very important. It is in sport. It's you have always radical formation. You have in immune system, you have the every immune reaction starts with formation of oxygen radicals in the normal metabolic activity. Oxygen radicals are formed. Now, I come back on what I already told before, protein synthesis. And a lot of people, when they want to have, let's say, muscle formation, they take a lot of amino acid preparations or protein preparation. They do not think that the first, before protein can be built, you need a transcription from the DNA on a RNA. This RNA is constantly built. It leaves the cell nucleus, goes outside, lines up here on a ribosome. Ribosomes are 60% nucleotides and 40% proteins. So here you have another part which is made of nucleotides. But then the single amino acids has to bring to this place, and these are so-called tRNA. So they come and bring the single amino acids to the place where they are connected. This connection again need nucleotides. So for a protein synthesis, you need DNA, you need messenger RNA, you need ribosomes, you need tRNA, and you need energy. When you have a lack of nucleotides, the protein synthesis will not function. And we have seen this in trials which we did with antibody production. We have seen sometimes antibody production which was 4 times higher compared to the control group. Now, I told you that our product is very important for all the cells which have a very quick cell multiplication. This bone marrow cells, or bone marrow derived cells, the intestinal flora. And this is also quite interesting because Bifidobacteria cannot produce nucleotides. So when you add nucleotides, the first thing will be a production of Bifidobacteria. And therefore, the pH in the gut start to change. It goes down. This means you have a more acid intestine. And some bacteria, they can only grow, for example, Colibacteria can only grow when the pH is around 5, 6. But when it goes down lower than 5, their production is going down. So we see a change in the whole gut flora with the nucleotides. And as I mentioned before, we have seen also an effect on some brain cells. And this is quite interesting. Also, there are quite a number of studies, mostly in China and in Japan, where they have looked at the memory effect of older people, older animals. And they have seen that this is really much, much improved by giving the nucleotides. This is not our work, but this is work at some of the universities. Then, I have already mentioned. Now I come on the immunological effect. And so there, we have seen, for example, here with when somebody has a transplant, it is forbidden, or it should not be given nucleotides, because as soon as you increase the immune system, then the graft is the rejection of the graft is going up. This is one of our contraindications. Okay, then we have seen here that we have, for example, a recovery from malnutrition. We are involved in some tests in Africa where mostly orphans, children from parents who died on AIDS. They are in Africa, mostly in orphans' house. And we are working with the company together, and we have seen that this reversal of the malnutrition, the immune suppression is much better. We have seen higher killer activity, more resistance against bacterial challenges. We have seen more interleukin-2, and all the neutrophils and total leukocytes is growing. Now here, this is just a trial which we have done in Edinburgh, where we have looked with people who have a cold, and we found here quite an interesting effect. So the people, they have to come in the onset of a cold, they have to come to the hospital, and they were getting the new cell, and you see here in the control group how quick it goes down the symptom. Here this was this is the new cell group, yeah. This was the tonsillitis, also the sinuses, which are normally you have pain here, and this is in the placebo group. So these people, they get the same capsules, but only the carrier, and you see that the symptoms went away quite quickly, and we know exactly that when I have an onset of a cold, normally it starts here. And I start to take quite a number of new cell. I take 3 capsules immediately. And 10 minutes later, the pain is gone. Sometimes it comes again after 3-4 hours, I take another 3. And normally I need only 3 times 3, and then everything is gone. Since the 25 years I worked with these products, I never have been a cold. And this is, I told you before already, this IgA. So we see even in sport that the immune system stays in a higher position. So this means the decrease because the defense always starts here in the mouse. The decrease of these antibodies in the mouse is much, much lower. Then here I mentioned before that we have, let's say, a growth-promoting effect on bifidobacteria, and therefore you have less of, let's say, other bacteria, let's say, bad bacteria in the gut. And now something very interesting. We have done quite a number of tests concerning the intestine, and we have seen that, for example, the villi is much bigger. And this was a trial which we have done on animals. And you see, this is the control group. And what you see here, when you look here, you have here, also I show you here, you see here outside the so-called mucosa layer. And you see here you have some rupture of the mucosa layer. And these are open doors for bacterial infections, for inflammation. And here we have the same animals, but only 21 days with nucleotides. And what you have seen here, that the formation of the mucosa layer is much better compared to here, And the villi structure is totally different to here. And this we have done in quite a number of animals. Also, we have started in fish up to the pigs. We have looked on how the development of the nucleotide of the villi are. And here we have done just some trials in IBS. The first trial was done in Canada, and we have seen here less problems with the diarrhea, and we have also seen a better an improvement of the incomplete evacuation. Then the bigger trial was done here in UK with Professor Dancy at the East London University. This was a double-blind placebo-controlled with 1 month washout, and it was a crossover trial. And you see here the abdominal pain, diarrhea, urgency, incomplete evacuation, flatulence, bloating, and constipation. And all these were significantly improved. And this was really very, 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 very impressive. And we have since then, our biggest sale is with our intestate. We have really, mostly in America, quite good results also with people who have Crohn's disease. And what is quite interesting is when you see you have an effect, a placebo effect, you always have a small placebo effect. But the interesting is when you have a baseline, you have an improvement with the placebo, but this stays linear. Whereas when you have the intestate, you have an improvement over the time. And so the longer you use it, the better it is. And sometimes we have even people who are absolutely free of IBS after half a year, something like that. So, here I go not in details because my time is over. this is just for the de novo synthesis. So what we have seen that supplementing purified nucleotides, and I repeat, purified nucleotides, because when you there are a lot of products on the market which tells a lot about nucleotides. When you look closer, you see that they are yeasts. But yeast, first of all, you have not the same composition of the nucleotides, because I said before that we have more pyrimidines. And when you think back on the Marmite, you see that purines in the Marmite is very high. This means with the yeast product, you cannot really achieve the same product, or that's the same effect. Because you have not the same, when you have, let's say, in the food already this kind of purines, this kind of pyrimidines, and you add something with the same level of purines, you make it even worse. And the absorption is better. So this is the effect which you have seen. So we have then really a very drastic effect in the body. So I think I kept my time. I kept my time. I hope you did not mind my Swiss English, Swinglish, Swinglish.